My name is Bill Young. I went 2 years to Cornell on a ride. I was in the School of Veterinary Medicine. And at that school, I continued the ride to give me room and board. In 1941, the boys on the football team all saw I Wanted Wings, starring Veronica Lake, with a peekaboo bang. And everyone went in then to the Air Corps recruiting to join, especially after a second lieutenant Air Corps said it's $75 a month in training and $125 plus another 50% for flight pay when you become a second lieutenant like I am. And a friend with me said, well, what is it like with the girls? He says, I have to fight them off. It's one of the greatest things that's ever happened to me. Up until that time, I only had one real joy in life, besides sleeping, and that was singing. I had sung for years and years and years, but particularly on team buses. Immediately after joining the Air Corps, I saw I had done the right thing. I had a few qualms because I thought maybe there might be some involvement in the war that was going on between the Japs and China, or the war that was going on between Germany, Britain, and France. However, I remembered what Roosevelt had said to Wendell Wilkie to put him down forever. And he said, I hate war. Eleanor hates war. And I want to assure each and every mother within the sound of my voice that your sons will never fight in a war. I thought, well, what the hell? I don't have anything to lose here. $75 a month to start. And $125. Uniform allowances, girls all over you. I thought this was a pretty damn decent thing. Besides, I can sing. So I joined and graduated in early 42. I went to Barksdale with the 319th group. Went to Baton Rouge, Louisiana with the 319th. And at that time I was in 438 squadron. I got cellulitis in my right leg and was left and returned to the 449th about summer of 1942. When I returned to Barksdale, I went to 476 squadron and I checked out as an instructor pilot and instructed with not too many hours of time in the B-26. Some of it was observer time. In those days, we were letting one man fly, another fly, and then a third man observe over the left seat pilot's shoulders. And, but I did fairly well in getting the idea of the straight wing 26. And then I became assistant flight commander and instructor of the A flight of the 476 bomb squadron. At that time, Millard E. Lewis was the colonel in charge of Barksdale. Whip Seymour was there. He was pretty wild. And Bob Herndon was my commanding officer. And after that, I started lecturing more and became fairly proficient in loads and loading and negotiating where the CG should be. And I instructed more, and I instructed more at night. And I rather enjoyed instructing at night because the students weren't too able to see where the horizon was, and they were better able to relax since they didn't know the attitude of the aircraft. And I went along on that for a few years, I mean a few months, and then I had a bit of difficulty because of some problems, like parking tickets. And after that, I went to base athletic officer, grounded for 4 months. And after I was grounded for 4 months, I had a hearing. By that time, I was in damn good shape. And from there, I went to over the northern route to the 449 squadron. And I was with the 449 squadron for a bit. And we did a lot of training. We did practice bombing. And there were lots of different maneuvers that we did in the practice bombing. And after that, I was moved to the 450 squadron. And in the 450 squadron, I did all of the usual missions. And after about 9 months there, I had about 50 missions. I went to the 344th group, where I was in the 494th bomb squadron. And I finished a tour there and went home and came back, and I did more missions with 494 squadron, and went up then to group headquarters, where I flew courier planes. And I flew the courier plane carrying mail and other contraband around from station to station throughout France and Belgium until 1945, at which time I came home, made application for medical school, was accepted in 1945, around April 30 or May 1st, and then went into medical practice after medical school. That's the whole story of it, and I didn't do much. Yes, I did. Pretty much two tours. With a trip on the 50. Yes.
Were you on the mission D-9?
Yes.
Did you know something about that?
I didn't see anything.
Just another mission.
Just another mission. I think that the PR nature of it is such that you could say it's a wonderful thing, all that sort of stuff. But I really didn't think much of the effect of the missions at that time. It wasn't as bad as I thought it was. My favorite toast in the lounge of the 322nd was a parody of Winston Churchill. I used to raise my beer on high and say, "Never before in the history of mankind have so many done so little to so few." And it was popularly received then. People thought, gee, this is great. But it isn't that way anymore. Now everything was great success every time. We hit the target and we did all of this sort of stuff. But I can remember not hitting the target a lot of times. I can remember going back and back and back. But I did fool around a little while, but we'll admit that. I used to enjoy flying the plane. The straight wing was the best before they added more wing length to it. And when they helped to take off, that was too much. It had become a Piper Cub by that time. No, they were they were getting up into the other side.
Yeah.
In the States there. That's the only place I flew a B-26 short wing. At Barstow. There may have been. There was a target plane at headquarters in Ring, which I think very well might have been a short wing. It was out of a plane. For instance, you could come in and take her off and pull the wheels from out of under her when it's coming down the runway, then milk up the flaps and then take her straight up. Had no armament. No steel to her. Flying like a homesick angel. Some of the field commanders took a certain amount of irritation at that. And from time to time, I used to be warned. Some of the fields were A-26s. They couldn't stand seeing a B-26 go up like that. You really
fun.
No, I left. I only flew B-26s. I went to the A-26 field where I had my co-pilot, Flight Officer John Chalmers. I lost him during the period I was on the ground at Barstow. I lost most of my original crew. Tragic sort of thing. Yes, I did. The finest balloon incident occurred between two B-26 pilots with the 450th. And the one had been terribly and mercilessly disparaged by the other, even to the point of bringing in two dogs, which acted as dogs did. And one of them was named after one of the other pilots. And this type of thing was almost uncalled for. And so the guy, we'll just have to assign some name to him, let's call him Hump, was feeling his oats, and we're coming back on a mission, and he said, gave all of the proper code, and the other guy's name was E-Dog. That was the airplane he flew. And he said, he gave the mission commander, Red Dog or whatever the hell it was, calling him on time, I don't know. So, what he said was, D-Dog, you may descend below the overcast now. And D-Dog peeled right off and descended below the overcast. So I get on there and said, how you like the blooms down there with Chelmsford? But he escaped without hitting a balloon. So it was not effective over the Hoffman ball bearing works in Chelmsford. But it scared the hell out of him. So those are the balloons. Drop one on Baghdad?